एवरीवन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट वर्डीनेस और रिडंडेंसी रिव्यू. सो इन इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज इट इज़ वेरी मच इम्पॉर्टेंट टू एडिट द रिपीटेड वर्ड्स इन योर पैराग्राफ, एसे और एनी स्टेटमेंट विच यू आर राइटिंग टू समवन. सो इफ यू आर रिपीटिंग सेम वर्ड्स अगैन एंड अगैन, इट डज नॉट लुक नाइस. एंड फॉर proper understanding of writing, you should always reduce redundancy, right? So for proper understanding of writing, you should know how to remove repeated words. Now, what is wordiness? Using more words than necessary. It is form of redundancy, results in the reader not paying attention to what you have to say. So sometimes when you keep on repeating words, what happens is that the reader's attention is diverted to something else rather than the statement or the paragraph or the essay. What you want to convey is not conveyed properly and the reader's attention is going elsewhere. Now, what is redundancy? Repeats a meaning by using synonym or definition. Example, she is a liar and does not tell the truth. So it is the same. Liar is also for not telling the truth, and does not tell the truth, that is also for signifies liar. So you can also reduce the statement to shorter version of it, like you can use she is a liar. That will convey that she does not speak truth. So we don't need to add that she is a liar and does not tell truth. That is not needed to be added to the sentence. How can you eliminate wordiness and redundancy in writing? So very, very important to remove this. Using action verbs versus be verbs. Use active versus passive voice. Combine short and choppy sentence. Eliminate synonyms using one strong word. So a very nice example here I have given, that she is a liar and does not tell the truth. You can only complete this statement by just stating that she is a liar. That will convey the same message as this statement, right? Then utilizing active voice rather than passive voice, right? The sentences should be more short and more precise, more informative, right? So use of action verbs like she's walking, she's talking. That will be more easy to convey the message, and it will be more easy to understand also. So let's practice. Suppose I have given you here one example. The rabid rabbits scamper and scurry from the fox. Correct form is the rabid rabbits scamper from the fox. Explanation: scamper and scurry are synonyms. So you can only utilize scamper, that the rabid rabbits scamper from the fox. So scamper and scurry are both similar thing. So eliminate scurry and utilize the rabid rabbits scamper from the fox. Next example is, my mom had to go to the ATM machine before we went to the mall, so we could go to the mall. So here we can correct it how? Here you have utilized, my mom had to go to the ATM before we went to the mall. So I have eliminated what? Machine, right? The reason behind eliminating machine is ATM's full form is all time machine. So I don't need to repeat the same word again. So if I remove ATM machine from the sentence, it will not change the meaning of the sentence and it will remain same. So that's how you remove wordiness and repeated words in the sentence. So you have to identify that which sentence has redundancy. We don't need any more problems, right? He went to the store to get milk at the store. Third, we could hardly wait for the good news. So it's very easy. Right, second statement, no need to repeat where you are going to the store, comma, at the store. So here you can see he went to the store to get milk at the store, right? It's not required, right? He's going to go to store only to get the milk, right? Dairy Queen is open Friday through Saturday 10 to 6 p.m. and Sunday from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. That is when it is open. So correct can be, Dairy Queen is open Friday to Sunday 10 to 6 p.m. Right? So you can always correct it. If the timings are same, you can join the sentence. So each day mentioned is open the same time. Only say 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. once is open. Should be said only once. So the timing should only be said once because it is opening at the same time, right? So that's how you remove redundancy. Next example is, Sally was shaking as she shivered and quickly begged, "Let's hurry up, it's freezing outside." So you hear what you can remove. So Sally shivered and quickly begged. So here what we have done, Sally was shaking as she shivered, right? So you can eliminate shaking because shivering means shaking, right? So Sally shivered and quickly begged, "Let's hurry up, it's freezing outside," right? Shaking and shivering is same. You can remove that, and that's how your sentence can be short and more easy to understand. Next is, as we get closer to the scene of the accident, we notice the victims were crying and bleeding the nearer we came, right? So as we got closer to the accident, we notice the victims crying and bleeding, right? So obviously they have been closer to the accident, so we don't need to repeat the same thing that we noticed the victim were crying and bleeding the nearer we came. So they are already close to the accident scene, right? So we have removed that and we have kept, we noticed the victims crying and bleeding, right? Were, so that's how we have reduced this sentence. Now here, identify where is the error. As soon as the movie was over, John made a beeline for the exit, looking for a quick exit, right? So the error is looking for a quick exit. So explanation, beeline means quick. Don't repeat quick again, right? So you can shorten the sentence by, as soon as the movie was over, John made a beeline for the exit. He wanted to quickly exit from the movie theater, right? So that's the same thing it is showing. That was all about redundancy and wordiness. I have discussed so many examples with you. So whenever you are trying to edit the paragraph or you are trying to make your conversation shorter and more precise, these kind of edit you can do in your sentence, right? Think about it, that what sentence are repeated, what words are repeated, and make it as short as possible.